Namaste students, welcome back to my channel. Students, from last three videos we are talking about hybridization, and I believe that now you know that how to find out the hybridization. But suppose you are giving some competitive exam, and in MCQ there is a question that out of the four options one has different hybridization than the other three, and if you find out the hybridization by the studied method, then the method is little bit time taking. So today in this video I am going to tell you a trick with the help of which you can easily find out the hybridization of the different molecules in very short time. And I made it very clear that this trick don't apply in the board exam. In the board exams you have to do in the board exam or in your class exam you have to do the proper method of finding the hybridization. This trick is for the competitive exams only. So without any delay, let's get started. So first of all, I tell you the different steps of this trick. You have to learn those steps, and after learning those steps it become very easy for you to find out the hybridization of different molecule. So the first step is you have to add the valence electron. You have to add the valence electrons of all the atoms which are present in the given molecule or ion. Whatever the molecule is given to us, or whatever the ionic species is given to us, first of all we have to add the total number of the valence electron of all the atoms present in that molecule or ion. So the first step is add all the valence electrons. Add all the valence electrons of all the atoms which are present in that particular molecule or ion. So add all the valence electrons of all the atoms which are present in that particular molecule or ion. Now if you have molecule, then you have to skip the second step. But if you have cation or anion, then you have to perform the second step. Now the second step is, if the ionic species is cation, then you have to subtract that much amount of charge from the total number of the valence electron. Means if we have cation, total number of valence electrons minus charge means, suppose the cation is positive, then I subtract one. If it is plus 2, then I subtract 2. If it is plus 3, then I subtract 3. So if it is cation, then total number of valence electron minus charge. And if it is anion, then total number of valence electron plus charge. Total number of valence electron plus charge. So this second step you have to perform when you have ions. But when you have molecules, you have to skip this step. Now the third step is, if the total number of valence electron, means if the total number of electrons which we are getting from first and the second step, if the total number of electrons, is less than or equal to 8, if the total number of electrons which we are getting from first and second, if these electrons are less than or equals to 8, then you have to divide that number by 2. Clear? If suppose total number of electrons we are getting 6, so you have to divide 6 by 2. If we are getting 5, you have to divide 5 by 2. If we are getting 3, then you have to divide 3 by 2. So in this way, if the number of electrons are less than or equals to 8, then you have to divide that number by 2. And then you have to add, quotient and remainder if any. You have to add quotient and remainder if any. Clear? But if the total number of electrons are from 9 to 56, then you have to divide the number by 8. And note quotient means you have to divide the number by 8 and then you have to note down the quotient. And if any remainder is there after dividing with 8, if there is any remainder, then you have to divide the remainder by 2. You have to divide that remainder by 2. And then you have to note quotient. Clear? If the number which we are getting from the first and the second step is between 9 to 56, then you have to divide the number by 8. After dividing by 8, you have to note down the quotient. If any remainder is there, you have to divide that remainder by 2 and again you have to note the quotient. Then you have to add, Q1, Q2 and the last remainder. Which we are getting after dividing by 2. And the number which we are getting here by adding quotient and remainder, that gives us hybridization or this value, Q1 plus Q2 plus remaining R, last R, this also gives the hybridization value. So, these are three steps with the help of which we can easily find out the hybridization of the different molecules. Now, I know there is a question in your mind that it will take more time to explain this process. So how it will be a trick? But when we kept these points in our mind, and by keeping these points in our mind, when we are going to solve the different example, then you believe that yes, it is a short trick to find out the hybridization of different molecules. So first you have to add all the valence electrons of all the atoms which are present in that particular molecule or ion. Then if it is ion, then you have to subtract the charge by the total number of valence electron if it is cation, or you have to add the charge with the total number of electron if it is anion. If the value which we are getting from first and second is less than or equals to 8, then you have to divide that number by 2 and you have to add quotient and remainder if any. Remainder may or may not be there. And if the total number of electron is between 9 to 56, then you have to divide the number by 8 and you have to note down the quotient. If any remainder is there, then you have to divide that remainder by 2 and you have to note down the second quotient. And then we have to add first quotient, second quotient and the last remainder. And these two values gives us the hybridization. Now we will solve some examples. Here is my first example, that is SO2. Now the first step is I have to add the valence electrons of all the atoms which are present in the molecule. So sulfur belongs to oxygen, and in oxygen we know that we have 6 valence electrons. So in sulfur also we have 6 valence electrons. So 6 plus 2 multiplied by 6, that is 6 plus 12, that is equals to 80. That is equals to 80. Clear? Now, because it is a molecule, so we don't have to perform the second step. So, we will directly jump to the third step. Now, because it is 18, so it is in between 9 to 56, so I have to divide the number 18 by 8. I have to divide the number 18 by 8, that is 8 to the 16, and I get the quotient 2. Sorry, I get the quotient 2 as well as the remainder 2. So, I'll note down the first question, that is 2. And because I am getting the remainder, so I'll divide the remainder by 2. When I divide the remainder by 2, it becomes, the second question becomes 1 and the last remainder becomes 0. So, Q2 is 1 and R is 0. Now, if I add Q1, Q2 and R, total sum becomes 3. Total sum becomes 3, and if it is 3, then the hybridization is sp2. The hybridization is sp2, because here it is 3. 3 means 1s, and if 1s is there, then there is a place of only 2p. So the hybridization is sp2. Hybridization is sp2. And you can check this hybridization by the original method also, by the basic concept also. Now, I take the second example, that is NO3 negative. So obviously, first of all, the first step, that is the number of valence electron. So, 5, the number of valence electrons are 5 plus 3 into 6. 5 in nitrogen and 6 in oxygen. So, 5 plus 3 multiplied by 6, that is 5 plus 18 and 23. It is 23. Now, because it is anion, so I have to add the charge. So, 23 plus 1, that is 24. So, the total number of electrons are 24. It is between 9 to 56. So, I have to divide this 24 from 8. 8, 3, 24 and 0. Now, because I don't have any remainder, so I don't have to divide by 2. And if I don't have to divide by 2, then I don't have second question and the remainder. So, here I have only Q1 and that is equals to 3. So, total sum is also 3. So, the total sum is also 3. And if it is 3, then hybridization is sp2. 1s and 2p. Easy or not? Now, third, CO3 2 negative. Now, first of all, what we have to do? Yes, we have to calculate the valence electrons. 4 plus 3 into 6. So, it is 4 plus 18, that is 22. And because here it is minus 2, so I have to add plus 2, that is equals to 24. So again I'll get 24. If I get 24, then I'll divide 24 by 8, I'll get 3. And if I get 3, remainder is 0, the total sum is 0, and the hybridization is sp2. I think it is not difficult. Now, next. Fourth is IF3. Now, iodine belongs to halogen family. In halogen family, we know that the number of valence electrons are 7. So, 7 plus 3 multiplied by 7. It means 7 plus 21, that is 28. So the valence electrons are 28, and because it is a molecule, we don't have to perform the second step. Now I divide this 28 by 8. Now 8 3 ja 24, I get the remainder 4. So I'll note the first question, that is 3. Now because I have here remainder 4, so I'll divide this remainder by 2. 2 2 ja 4, and I get the second question, that is 2, and the remainder 0. So second question is 2, and the remainder, last remainder is 0. So if I do this, then the total sum that is equals to 5. The total sum is 5, and if the total sum is 5, the hybridization is sp3d. Clear? And with the help of the hybridization, you can also predict the shape. In this, it is sp3d. And here, we have only 3 fluorine with iod, and we know that halogen forms only one bond. It means one fluorine form only one bond. So here we have total number of electron pairs 5. Out of these 5 pairs, 3 will form bond pairs, and the 2 will form lone pair. And if the 2 will form lone pair, the shape is T-shaped. Here we have total how many electron pairs? 3. And here we have how many oxygen? 2. So 2 will form bond pair, and the 1 will form lone pair. So here the hybridization is sp2, but the shape is bent. Clear? So in this way, we can predict the shape of that particular molecule also on the basis of the hybridization. But this trick is to find out the hybridization. Let us take some more example. Fifth is BrF5. Now, boron belongs to halogen family. So, 7 plus 5 into 7. So, 7 plus 35, that is 42. Now, I'll divide this 42 number by 8. When I divide this 42 number by 8, 8, 5, ja, 40. Here it is 2. So I divide this remainder with 2, and I get question 1. So first question is 5. Second question is 1. And the final remainder is 0. So the total sum is 6. And if it is 6, then the hybridization is sp3d2. 6 orbitals, 1 orbital of s, 3 orbital of p, and 2 orbital of d. So total becomes 6. Total number of electrons are 6. Clear? So the hybridization is sp3d2 because the total sum is 6. Now, 6th. I'll take XeF4. That is xenon fluoride. Now, xenon is a noble gas. So, in noble gas, we know that the valence electrons are 8 plus 4 into 7. So, 8 plus 28. That is equals to 36. So when I divide this 36 number by 8, 36, then 8 4 ja 32, I get 4. Now because I am getting the remainder, so I'll divide the remainder by 2. So 2, 4, and I get the quotient 2. So I am getting 2 quotient here. Question first is 4, and the second question is 2, and the last remainder is 0. And because I am getting two questions, so the total sum is equals to the sum of these two questions, that is 6. And if it is 6, the hybridization is sp3d2. The hybridization is sp3d2. Now, if you remember, if we have sp3d2 hybridization, the proper geometry should be square bipyramidal when we have all bond pairs. But in this, we have only 4 bond pairs. It means out of 6, 4 are bond pairs and 2 are lone pairs. And when 4 bond pairs and 2 lone pairs are there, then the shape is square planar. So in this way, we can predict the shape also. Now, let us take more example. XeO2F2. It seems a little bit difficult. Now, 8 plus 2 into 6 plus 2 into 7. 6 oxygen valence electron, 7 fluorine valence electron. 8 plus 12 plus 14. 8 plus 12 plus 14, and that is equals to 34. That is equals to 34. That is 8 plus 12 plus 14. That is equals to 34. Now, I have to divide this 34 by 8. So, 8 4 is 32. I get the remainder 2. And I divide this remainder by 2. And I get the question 1. So, the first question is 4. And the second question is 1. And the remainder is 0. So the total sum becomes 5. If the total sum becomes 5, it is sp3d. It is sp3d. sp3d. 5, 1, 3 plus 1, that is equals to 5. Suppose I have chlorate ion, ClO4 negative. ClO4 negative. Now, in this, chlorine belongs to halogen family. So, 7 plus 4 into 6. So, 7 plus 24, that is equals to 31. And because it is anion, so 31 plus 1, that is equals to 32. So, I divide this 32 by 8. 32 divided by 8, 8 4 is 32, and the remainder is 0. And because remainder is 0, so I will not divide this remainder by 2. So I have only one question, that is 4. So if 4, so total sum will also equal to 4, and the hybridization is sp3. So you can easily find out the hybridization by this method in your mind, if your maths is little bit good, not too much good, this method don't require too much good maths. But if you have a good understanding or you have good calculating power, then you can use this trick in your mind also. No need of paper, nothing. Now I give you some molecules and you tell me that what are the hybridization of those molecules without using the basic concept, by using this trick. But I am repeating again that this trick is for the competitive exam, not for your school exams. Not for your school exam. This is for the MCQs, not for the 2 or 3 marks questions. So, here are certain molecules and you have to tell the hybridization of these molecules by using this trick. So, first is SO4, 2 negative. Second is CO2. Third is XeOF4. Fourth is XeO3F2. And the fifth is H2SO3. So, you have to tell me the hybridization of these molecules by using this trick. So students, I hope you have enjoyed this trick. I'll see you in my next video with a new topic.